Hi, and welcome back to another episode of Sailing Embla. I'm just making some breakfast. Just a simple omelette or something. I think eggs is truly the most underrated food in the world. It's so great to have these guys on the boat. They keep so long and they don't go bad. And I'm going to chop up some onions to have in there before they go bad. And today I was planning on staying here in Sandnes and just clean the boat, wash some clothes, like so. This is how I like to chop the onions. And I think I'm going to put some garlic in there. But everything starts with a good breakfast, don't you think? One will do. I'll just stir this around a little. And in with eggs. May not look that tasty because it has such a bad color, but hey, it's only breakfast. It's not like I have a date or anything. I probably won't serve this on a date. No, hold on. And of course we need to have some coffee to go with that. That wasn't that erotic. There you go. Breakfast is served.
Hey, Shabby.
Breakfast time.
It's gonna be lovely.
It's a warm, beautiful day here in Sandnes. And in fact, it has been this way for several months now. I think we just had one or two, maybe 3 days or something of rain. And other than that, sunny, warm, dry. It's so great living on the boat in summer, contrary to living on the boat in the winter, at least up here in the high latitudes. I don't complain. I love it. It's t-shirts and shorts everyday weather, but the farmers around here are starting to complain because they, for them, this is a drought. So they can't grow any crops or anything. But for me, I love it. I truly do love it.
So, beautiful.
Now, last time on Sailing Embla, I was in Lysefjord, and I said I was going to leave the next day, which I did. Unfortunately, we had some bad weather. Well, not bad like a storm or anything, but it was clouded, and it was one of those days when it rained. Actually, we had headwind all the way in. I can't fathom how I can have headwind all... No, I'm lying now. I didn't have headwind the last, very last part of the sail. I could actually sail. But the two-thirds of the trip, it was headwind. And also, the telephone stopped. Telephone, my camera, aka iPhone. It decided to just stop and turn itself off. And I couldn't get it started again. It was not like a bad battery or anything. Every time I started to or tried to restart it, it just showed me that stupid Apple symbol or a thin white line. And no matter how much I charged it, it wouldn't start again. So I was really scared, really scared of losing every footage on this trip because I had a lot on the camera and I hadn't transferred it yet. So it solved itself because I came back here to Sandnes. And I went to work the next day and I could do some upgrading on the telephone with new software and it started again. So hopefully, keep my fingers crossed, it will work sometime more. With no further ado, this is how it went on the trip back.
Now we have just left Lysefjord behind me there, and we are heading out. Today we have about 8 meters per second in wind just against us. So we are gonna try to do some sailing. Hopefully it can be done in this place here. It's quite narrow. Today it's a little foggy, as you can see up in the mountains there. And I hope we don't get any rain. It's kind of crazy when you stand here. It doesn't really look that tall, but when you know that this is 1,000 meters and you can place 10 or so Statue of Liberties on top of one another to get to the top there, or 3 Empire State Buildings, that is amazing stuff.
And in there, I don't know if you can see it. There you go. There's a lighthouse, and beside that is I don't know, wind sausage that shows the wind direction. And that is because it's here that the base jumpers land usually, and they jump off these cliffs here, and then they'll just land there and a boat picks them up. I'm not really sure, but I think that up there just behind the cloud there is Skjærhøgbolten, where I was. It should be behind there. It looks about right anyway. And now it has started to rain a little, so you can see here on the windows, not much, but just a little. It's not as cloudy anymore, but I shouldn't say that, not on wood. The white thing there is of course the old power station, and I guess people lives there in these houses. I have no idea. A lot of these places here in Norway that used to be thriving communities are only summer homes nowadays, because people have to commute to work. It's hard to get by living in places like this. It's too bad though. Wouldn't it be cool to just live in a tiny place like this, where you know everybody? And awesome nature. I think it would be kind of cool. And of course, it's starting to rain, so this isn't working. I have to go by engine. But I'm gonna use the sail because it gives me a knot or 1.5 extra or something. It helps a little.
The view from inside the Dodger. Huh? It's a leak here. You see this thing? This here? That's a water drop. Thought I fixed the leak.
And it's time for a little update, I think. We are still in the fjord. It is a long fjord. It takes time, you know, to get out of there. And especially when you have to motor all the way. And we still have the wind dead ahead. So I can't start sailing yet, but I'm hoping when we get out of the fjord that the wind will continue have this direction. So it's not only the fjord that forces the wind that way. That would mean we can hoist the sails as soon as we get out of here, and we gain some speed, because now we are doing about 4 knots, and well, we are getting somewhere, but we are getting somewhere slow. That's where we are at now. It has stopped raining, at least. You can see there are still some clouds here and there, but nothing really in the horizon, so the weather has improved. And we are here, as you can see. We started from here and we have gone to this point. So now we just need to get out of the fjord, and this is what I'm hoping, that the wind is coming from this direction now. It's blowing in like this. But when I get out, I'm gonna sail up, and I'm hoping that the wind will continue blowing in like so. We shall see.
maybe I'll just go into Stavanger. It's shorter, looks shorter anyway, than going all the way down to Sandnes.
Yesterday I went on this incredible hike up to the Pulpit Rock actually, and I talked about it in an earlier episode, I think, when we sailed into Lysebotten. I talked about Tom Cruise hanging on there in his new movie Mission Impossible something, and this time we went by car, by the way. Elizabeth, a friend of mine, had a day off and she brought her kids, and we went up all together. And Shabby too got to go on a mountain hike, and I think I was in the right, you know, when I left her going to Shadow, because going up to Pulpit Rock was much easier than going to Shadow. So, but she went up and she came down again, but as soon as we came back to the car, no more Shabby, she fell asleep. I think she had it. So if I'm going to bring her along on trips like that in the future, I think I need to set aside more time. Maybe stay up there during the night or something. But there were a lot of people up there. A lot of people. Well, it's in the season anyway. Well, today the boat looks like a bomb went off in here. So I need to clean her. And one of the things I need to do is wash some clothes. Unfortunately, living on a boat, your clothes get dirty here too, so sometimes you need to clean them. That's what we're gonna do now. So, let's go. This is the laundry place in this harbor.
Just gonna throw everything in there.
I'm not picky when it comes to colors and stuff.
Don't mix the colors.
On this boat, I only wash in 60 and 40. Every underwear and every socks at 60, and t-shirts and pants and stuff, that's 40. It cost 20 kroner, which is about $2.50, and you just put it in here and press the play button, and then we are done here. I just need to fill up on some water and I'm done. There you go. Now the wind is picking up and we have some clouds coming in. I'm wondering if this is one of those days when it's gonna rain. And I'm done. The boat is clean as a whistle. I've even cleaned the floors. You can eat off those floors now. I wouldn't recommend it though, but you could, I guess. Everything is clean and nice again, just like it should be. On a liveaboard boat.
Hey Shabby!
And everything is back in its original place. And oh, it's so much better when it's orderly in the boat.
Shabby the dog!
And I guess that is pretty much it for this video. So please leave me a comment in the comment sections below and give me one of these. Or maybe one of these if you really didn't like this video, and don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell icon below there so you don't miss out on any new videos. And until next time, you take care and I will see you there.
I will be watching you, and Shabby will be watching you too with her evil eye. And you don't want to mess with this dog. She's a killer. Aren't you a killer? Yeah.